Hello, this is JRay5021. I was trying to get a little proactive today and try to find out how I could get some water tested myself in Southern California. Since nothing is being done in this state, or at least it's being done and we're not being told, so I thought I'd try to, you know, see what the process is and how much it costs and da 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 da. I came across this article in Coup, C-O-U-P Media Group, and it was an article about two guys who I don't know how they came across in Santa Clara County at the water recharge pond. They saw a couple of guys in hazmat suits and started filming. These guys were taking radiation samples, or testing, sorry, radiation testing, not water samples. And then they actually took a video. Hard to understand what he says with the traffic noise in the background, but he says, "This is the last time I'm going to ask you to move away." So these gentlemen sent this video and their statement to Coup Media. Coup Media contacted the Santa Clara Water District, and one of the employees there said that he was not aware of the Santa Clara Water District doing any type of testing other than regular testing regards to radiation. Then he also said if anything, any testing was being performed anywhere within the Santa Clara Water District, he would know. So, you know, this is, they just think we're so stupid. So the author of this, his name is Planet X. He goes on to mention further that possible nuclear contamination has been suspected in California, of course, where people are seeing unidentified people walking around highly populated areas in California, apparently testing for level increases. Radiation sickness, radiation contamination, acute radiation sickness are all names for exposure to different types and levels. How you are affected by radiation and what symptoms you experience will greatly depend on how much and how long you are exposed. Smaller doses can result in gastrointestinal effects such as nausea and vomiting, and symptoms similar to falling blood counts like infection and bleeding. Larger doses of radiation exposure over a long period of time can result in numerous neurological effects as well as rapid death. Treatment of severe radiation syndrome is generally a long-term supportive issue with blood transfusions and antibiotics. So I'm gonna say, let's start holding our doctors accountable. If you have nausea and vomiting, flu-like symptoms, headaches, nosebleeds, anything, go to the doctor. Go into the ER room. Create mass panic in the ER. Make a scene. Do whatever you have to do to get some lab results and be seen and be tested. If we just sit back and say, oh, well, I don't feel good, gee, you know, there's an awful lot of people who have been sick lately. An awful lot of people. Now, I don't know if that's just that with the chemtrails on top of on top of the radiation plumes. You know, I think they're kind of dialing in the chemicals in the spraying lately, because it looks a little different. And I'm sure that, you know, they've got to try to dial that in, so that maybe they want to hit us with more aluminum, which affects the brain a lot more, keep us dummied down and confused and lethargic. You know, I don't know. I'm just guessing, because, you know, these are mad scientists at the helm here. And I, for one, am going to scream before I crash and burn. So, God bless.